Home Assistant Yellow is a smart home hub designed from scratch for the best free and open source home automation platform available at the moment called Home Assistant. Yellow can be used by beginners or by advanced users with the same success. But what is good and what is bad about it? Let's find out. Home Assistant Yellow is not the first attempt of Nabucasa team, that's the team behind the Home Assistant, to make a hardware smart home hub. Their first one was the Home Assistant Blue, which was more likely a rebranding of an Android N2 device with a nice blue Home Assistant logo on the case. Nevertheless, the blue is now discontinued and yellow is the successor. The brains of the yellow is a Raspberry Pi Compute Module 4 or CM4. And the device is also having a built-in Silicon Labs Zigbee 3.0 chip inside that allow integrating Zigbee devices out of the box and also makes the device future-proof as it is ready for the upcoming new smart home standard called Matter. If some of the smart home words and abbreviations are not so clear for you, I have something that could help you. It is a free smart home glossary that is available on my website automatelike.pro/glossary. Inside this glossary, you will find simple but useful explanations of the most used words in smart home world. So, download it right now. Now let's continue. Home Assistant Yellow does not have Wi-Fi, Z-Wave or Bluetooth support. Let's analyze that a bit more, as it is important. And here are my major remarks of the device. To connect the Yellow to your home network or internet, you can use the gigabit LAN port of the device, so lacking a Wi-Fi is not such big of a deal. It is even fine, as connecting your main smart home hub via Wi-Fi is not a good idea overall. Next is the lack of Z-Wave support. The idea of having a smart home hub ready for every major smart home wireless protocol is very appealing, and I really wanted that would be the case with Yellow, but unfortunately this is very hard to be accomplished. Z-Wave have a different communication frequencies for different continents. Also, as far as I know, Z-Wave certification process is very hard and expensive. As you might guess, that would add to the total cost of the device. Correct me if I'm wrong here in the comments, but I have the feeling that Z-Wave is lagging behind Zigbee and Wi-Fi lately. Z-Wave is not as popular as the other wireless protocols among the new and exciting products that are released in the later years. So, if you really need Z-Wave, the best option will be to get a Z-Wave stick like this one, and your problem will be solved. All of that makes lack of Z-Wave somehow understandable for me. But what I don't understand here at all is why there is no Bluetooth in Yellow. This, in my humble opinion, is the biggest drawback of this device overall. Bluetooth is a must for me, and I don't want to use USB Bluetooth sticks, as there are some compatibility issues with some of them, and also this will take one of the USB ports available, and Yellow have only two of them. So one for the Z-Wave stick and one for the Bluetooth stick, and you're out of USB ports. Again, lacking of Z-Wave and Wi-Fi is not so important to me, but Bluetooth is. I hope this will be sorted out in the next hardware project of Nabucasa team. And that concludes my complaints about the Home Assistant Yellow. Now, I'll try to show you why this device really shines in Yellow. The first thing that I have in mind is that you have the possibility to upgrade the device in the future if that is needed. As I said in the beginning, the brain of Yellow is a Raspberry Pi Compute Module 4, which can be replaced. You just need a brain surgeon. When Raspberry Pi Org releases a new Compute Module 5 or 6, for example, chances are that the form factor will remain the same, and you'll be able to upgrade the brain module of your Yellow device very easily. The standard flagship version of Yellow have 2 GB of RAM and 16 gigabytes of eMMC storage, and if the storage is not enough for you, there is an M.2 extension port available, so you can plug a solid-state drive for more space. Next good thing about the Yello is the support. You should expect a first-class support here, and everything will be most probably work as it should be. If not, you have the chance to say, "Dear Home Assistant team, you sold me a Home Assistant Yello." But as you can see, mine is not quite Yello. So, can you please update that OTA ASAP? Kidding aside, if there are some glitches with the Home Assistant OS and Yello, I'm sure they will be fixed lightning fast, so you can sit back and relax while the Nabucasa dev team working their asses off to deliver the fix for you. Next good thing about Yello is that there is no vendor lock-in and everything is open, so you can do whatever you want. You want to stay local only? No problem. Home Assistant OS and Yello can work without internet. Or you want to connect your Home Assistant to internet, but you are afraid that your data will be leaked. No worries. Everything is open sourced here, and it is verified by hundreds of people exactly for such kind of potential issues, and none was found. And because the brain of the Yello is coming from Raspberry Pi organization, you are free to install any Raspberry Pi compatible operating system if Home Assistant OS is not your thing. Yello is sold in three different flavors. The standard Yello or the flagship version have everything you need to get started with Home Assistant, as everything is pre-installed. You just have to plug in the power supply and the Ethernet cable, both of which are included in the package, and you see Home Assistant in your network in no time. Next option is a Yello kit with power over Ethernet. If you choose this option, you will not have a power supply, but you'll be able to power the device over the Ethernet. Also, the brain, that was the Raspberry Pi CM4 module, is not included in the kit, and you have to use your own, which is great if you already have such module available or you want to buy a more powerful one. The final option is called Yello Kit with Power Supply, and as the name suggests, you receive a device with power supply and without power over Ethernet support, just like the flagship model, and also without the compute module 4. So again, you have the chance to use your own compute module or to order a more powerful one. As summary, with first Yello flavor, that is the flagship, it is all plug and play, while with the second and third options, you receive a kit and some assembly, and Home Assistant installation will be required by you. And while I'm talking about Home Assistant installation, I must say that Home Assistant Yello is not the only option to have Home Assistant. Options are a lot, and there are 4 official methods to install Home Assistant on different devices. I have a Home Assistant webinar, and I want to officially invite you as I'm talking about these 4 official methods, plus one secret, not so official, but super easy way to start Home Assistant in under 5 minutes. Go to my website and register now. The webinar is completely free. Now, the big question is, should you buy the Home Assistant Yello? I'll try to cover the most common situations here. First, if you have a Raspberry Pi 4, don't bother buying Yello. Just buy a Zigbee stick instead, if you need Zigbee or Matter support. If you have a Raspberry Pi 3 or older, then Yello will be a good upgrade for you, and you can go ahead and buy one. If you have Home Assistant Blue device, some will say that you even downgrade your hardware if you buy Yello. That is because Odroid N2 is pretty powerful device and you don't need to buy Yello. Again, just buy a Zigbee stick if that is needed. If you have some kind of Intel Nuke or an always-on computer or a virtual machine, stay as you are, unless you have some glitches with, I don't know, power consumption or stability issues of your system as a whole. If you don't have anything yet, Yellow is a perfect device for you, and I can two hands recommend it. Unfortunately, due to the global electronic component shortage, you have to wait a bit for the Yellow if you order it now. But there is a good Bulgarian saying for that. The good things happen slowly. I'm Kirill, and I'm done speaking. Bye!